I'm Dr. Laura Schlessinger. Welcome again to our YouTube channel, which we answer your questions and show you my dog and the people I work with, and we have all kinds of things happening here, so always check it. I was raised by my grandma listening to you. I remember growing up hearing that all too often women strive for short-term gratification instead of long-term satisfaction. Now I'm ready to turn 30 and could really use a refresher in that course. Is there any way I can receive an update or something to refresh my own memory on these talks? It would be the utmost and helpful as to where I am in life, trying to remember about what was said about long-term satisfaction. Wow, this is so timely, because these days, most women out there are pigs. Are you shocked that I said that? Do you think I'm talking about you? I might be. Is it 1, 2, 3 minutes, 3 hours, 3 days, 3 dates, and you're already having sex with somebody you don't know? That's the short-term gratification. That's the pretending there's a relationship. That's the pretending that somebody gives a darn about you. That's the pretending that somebody respects you, cares about you. You know what? Here's the deal. You know he's in love with you when he wants to protect you more than he simply wants to do it to you. Not that he'll stop wanting to do it to you, but you're getting my drift. So the short-term imaginary satisfaction that I have a boyfriend and he's in love with me because he's doing it with me all the time might make your ego feel good. But then again, after a while, when he gets bored and I get the call going, I don't know what happened. I thought we were so close. I loved him. Instead of actually getting to know somebody. I went to an Orthodox, super duper Orthodox Jewish wedding one time. This couple had known each other for a year, had not even touched fingers, not even handing somebody an ice cream cone that fingers can accidentally touch, nothing, no touching. They spent a year talking, doing things together with chaperones, really getting to know one another, developing awe and admiration and respect and a whole lot of excitement. The wedding was the first time they touch each other. And she has a veil and he can't see her, and then they reveal a veil, and we do some of that in generalized weddings, and she walks around him 3 times. His glasses are broken. I mean, it is beautiful. And for the first time, the relationship becomes physical. But it becomes physical in a context. And that's what so many of you don't understand when you're going for the immediate gratification. And you guys too, because girls are making it so easy. You're just doing one girl after another and wondering why it doesn't mean anything. Because sex without a foundation of love and admiration gets boring. And that's why you move on to the next girl or the next guy. So really, try to get to know someone, because ultimately, if you're going to be with them for 50, 60 years till death do you part, a very small percentage of the time in each day goes to getting it on. The rest of it goes to being two little old people in a park, hunched over a little bit from arthritis, holding hands and walking together. That's the long run. I'm Dr. Laura Schlessinger. See you on the next YouTube.